Welcome friends to this new exciting NPTEL sponsored course on Introduction to Experiments in Flight. Now no more in classroom, we will be actually flying with the airplane and try to see whatever you have learned in the classroom, can you validate through experiments or not. That is why this course is suitably titled Introduction to Experiments in Flight. You will appreciate as we talk about experiments. Once you design an experiment, it is extremely important to know what is the health of the instruments which you are going to measure, and based on those instruments, we are going to check whatever theory you have understood in the classroom. For example, we have a Peters tube, and you know the Peters tube is extremely important because it gives you airspeed and the display comes in the cockpit. Similarly, you would like to know how much control deflection you have given, how much stick force your pilot is applying, what are the orientation of the airplane, what is the engine status of the airplane, what is the RPM of the engine, what is the manifold pressure of the engine, because I need to know all this data to process it suitably so that I can see how good is our model validation. So all those details will be there in this course, and in the next few stages I'll go inside a cockpit and show you what are the instruments and how we're going to measure it. As I promised, we'll temporarily say goodbye to the classroom. You could see we are inside the cockpit, and our purpose is to know what are the instruments we will be actually focusing on to get the relevant information. We needed three important readings. One was airspeed, which is sensed through the Peters tube, which I have shown you earlier, and displayed in an airspeed indicator. And you could see that airspeed is given here in this analog sensor or analog display. Similarly, I need the manifold pressure. Manifold pressure will be displayed here. We need RPM. RPM will be displayed here. Similarly, we need very important outside air temperature, which will be displayed here. And as long as you are cruising, you will get a true airspeed, which will be displayed just above the outside air temperature. These readings we have to take and we'll be using for deducting the laws of physics which is being applied for aerospace engineering. Thank you very much. Thank you.